Blackstone presents the Thriller Zone podcast, created and produced by David Temple. Hello, and welcome to the debut of the Thriller Zone. I'm your host, David Temple. I got to thinking the other day, I love thrillers. I love writing thrillers. I love reading thrillers. And I love speaking to thriller writers about their passion. What makes them tick? So I thought, why not create a whole new podcast and thus the Thriller Zone? I want to say out of the gate, thanks for your patience as I am broadcasting from beautiful Lake Tahoe. And in the background, you're going to be hearing boats going by and people shouting and so forth and some construction. But, you know, I thought after a year of COVID, does it really matter? Everyone's kind of gotten adjusted to things in the raw. I really wanted to have my debut of the Thriller Zone to feature a thriller writer that is right there on the cusp of blowing up, and I think we found her. Unfortunately, she lost a dear friend, and she has, as you can imagine, been feeling low and didn't really want to be on camera, so we're just going to go with the audio version. Completely understandable. I do want to tell you about her, though. May Cobb earned her MA in literature from San Francisco State University, and her essays and interviews have appeared in The Washington Post, The Rumpus, Edible Austin, and Austin Monthly. Her debut novel, Big Woods, won multiple awards, and I think we're going to see the same thing happen with her latest thriller, The Hunting Wives. A Texas native, she lives in Austin with her family. Please welcome my friend and yours, May Cobb.
Hey, David.
Hi. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Yes, I'm sorry I'm not presentable for video's sake. I can't get my eyes to quit being puffy. So,
well, first of all, thoroughly understand that. I'm so sorry for your loss. I won't belabor the point, but I can't imagine what you're going through. So know that our thoughts and prayers are with you.
Thank you so much, David. I really appreciate it. And you're in San Diego, right?
That's where I'm based. I'm actually sitting right on the edge of Lake Tahoe right now.
Oh, nice.
It is. I thought San Diego was beautiful, but Lake Tahoe is breathtaking.
Isn't it, though? That's so great. I've only been there once, and I drove through, but I couldn't believe how pretty it was.
I want you to take this in the best way possible. It's going to sound maybe a little guyish. I don't mean the insult. When I first picked up this book, Susie Spencer, by the way, our mutual friend, thank you to Susie. Yeah. Introducing us. But she said, David, you want to read a book that you can't put down? I'm like, yeah, hi. So I picked up and reached out to you and picked up The Hunting Wives and started reading. And I'll be honest with you, at first I thought, this is a chick book.
For sure. Right?
And I'm reading, I'm like, which I got no problem with. I grew up in a household full of girls and I'm married and I love women. And, you know, I'm thinking to myself, I can see why gals would really love this book. And I'm like, and I'll turn to my wife and I'm like, I think this is going to be good. Let's see how it goes. And May, I got, I don't know, a third of the way in. And I'm like, oh boy. And I got a little bit further. I'm like, oh boy. And and you had me hooked.
Wow. Thank you so much. And thank you, Susie, if you're listening. David, thank you. That is the biggest compliment ever.
Well, I mean it. I thought, you know, the lipstick and the bullets on the front, that gets your attention. I don't care if you're a guy or a gal. And then the quotes, the people that are talking about it. I want to read this one quote that is my number one favorite. Author A.J. Finn says, and I'm abbreviating it just a bit, in a cocktail shaker, blend Big Little Lies and Lucy Foley's The Guest List and add a jigger of the Stepford Wives.
Yes, I was very grateful for that blurb from him.
You can't ask for much better than that, can you?
No, I was so grateful. I really was. When that one came through, I was like, wow, because I'm a big fan of Woman in the Window, and it was the thriller I was reading as I started writing this one, actually. Those are very nice comps.
Well, let's start with the classic question that probably everyone asks you. Being a writer myself, I find myself asking some of the same questions.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.